Did you ever wonder how you can recover deleted photos or pictures, documents, PDFs, spreadsheets, formats such as RAW file, JPEG, GIF, PNG, and all sorts of video formats even directly from your digital camera, as well as erase or digital files and directories from your hard drive? Introducing the new Data Trace Recovery Software, a lightweight, easy-to-use, professional digital recovery solution that is created by Data to Us, is a software that will recover data due to deletion, accidental format, partition loss, software crash, file damage due to virus infection, and other similar instances. Recovery features include quick scan, deep scan, search by date, search by file size, file preview, media file recovery, email files recovery, Microsoft Office files recovery, recovers from unbootable drive. The software supports FAT and NTFS, to name a few, and the system compatibility includes Windows XP, Vista, Windows 7, and Windows 8. The Data Trace Recovery comes in three varieties. One is the standard. This is the Windows base entry, and this is compatible with Windows 2000, Windows XP, 2003, Vista, Windows Server 2008, Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows Server 2012. The professional version, which has features to recover files from dynamic disk and Linux-based system. The third one, which is the ultimate version, is ideal for individuals or companies that offer professional recovery service. And this version is compatible with Windows XP, Windows Vista 7 and 8, servers 2003, 2008, and 2012. Hi guys, I'm going to show you how to use the Data to Us Data Trace Recovery. Let me open when you open the program, it will show this window here. Before we do the let me introduce you to the links here on the top, these icons here. First, we have the option. If you click the option, the default is 5 gigabytes maximum size, so you can set it to whatever file size you have. This is good if you have like limited space on the destination drive, and there's also a path to which whatever you recover or the files that you're going to restore goes to this particular folder or this particular path. And it comes with a easy to follow help option, like for instance how to use this manual. And some other terms you might as well read this, so at least you get some ideas. What files to recover. And the features. And system compatibility. The About Us goes to their website. And this is where you register the license copy. Okay, so again, as I told you, there are three main features. First is the quick scan. Right now I have a SD card I just placed into my computer, and I wanted to recover some photos that I moved from this device to my hard drive, and as well as the ones that I've deleted. For the quick scan, this E here is my SD card. Okay, guys, there's a next and a back buttons here. First, sorry. Highlight whatever drive you want and then hit next. Select this disk here. Okay. These are the files inside this particular folder, which is the 109 underscore PANA. Actually, this is my Panasonic digital camera. But again, this is the SD card I used. Let me show you what's inside my actual this SD card. There's a folder that's 109 PANA. I have some few. So these are the actual photos right now. So when you try to recover, it's going to recover some more. So okay, let me close this now. And then if I hit next, you can uncheck particular files. If you're aware or if you're familiar with the dates, that would help a lot because you can just uncheck whatever dates that are not necessary to recover. So, like for instance, you lost a file on that particular date, you can just recover on that specific date. So at least you can save some space when you restore to your destination path. There's an option here to search, and you can also preview. I would highly recommend that you use the complete scan. For me, quick scan is just like browsing what's inside or what can be recovered, but the complete scan is the one that can really recover all your deleted and your and the files that you move from one folder to another, or from one directory, or from one drive to another drive. Okay, so this is the recommendation I'm gonna show you guys. Complete scan. Again, select the E, which is my SD card. Click next. If you notice, there's some options here. Just hit recommended. Hit next. It may take a while because it's going to display all the files that can be recovered. Let me pause this. I don't want to take your time. And then I will come back as soon as it's done. Okay, guys, after it's done, it shows this window. There are two, if you see this, there are two disks that in the quick scan it was only one disk, which is disk number one here. For this particular for the complete scan, it showed two disks. So let me highlight both. Okay, even from way back in January of 2011, it was it's showing here. Like for instance, if I this particular file, which is 2011, January 4, if I show you my original, let me go to my original SD card. Okay. It is. If you notice, the earliest dates that is shown here is August 1, 2011. But in my, let me close this, in my recovered data, it shows here January 4. So let me show you how I could see what are those or what's in this line here. Okay, so highlight that and then select preview. Say preview here. Okay, if you notice, what is this? This is the picture. Yeah, let me get another good one here. Hold on. You can either double click or just, yeah, this is the picture. Actually, this is the, you can just maximize it. I just content to this particular space because I cannot cover all the spaces, too big. The picture is just too big. But anyhow, you can, my point here is you can preview, and then if you just want to recover that particular image, you can deselect some other folders here or files here, and then concentrate on that particular files. Like for instance, you just wanted to recover this three files here from this disk. You can uncheck this one here, and then please note, the more files you check here, the more it takes time for you to recover. It may take hours, may take a few minutes. Depends on how many files you're trying to recover. So for the purpose of this video, let me just show you some few examples, so at least it's easier and it's quicker for us to finish. No, you don't wanna stay long here, as long as, okay, let me pause. Okay guys, I just selected the files that I want to recover. So so if you're sure about what you're going to do, hit next here. Oops, I forgot. For the for the destination folder, make sure that you have enough space in your destination. In my case, I'm gonna put it in my recovered files. Let's say I'm gonna rename this to April 28th. This is the time I created a video and select a folder. Okay, so when you have selected the particular path here, hit next and the process goes. So it's just so quick because I only selected a few files. Okay, so let's see what I have recovered. So in the lost files, lost folders, see, These are the files from the ones I took way back in January 4, 2011. So that's how easy it is, guys. There's a link in the description, so to learn more about it. And I'm gonna be coming up with another tutorial for the particular software that is data to us card recovery. That software is intended solely for digital cameras, and it's a new one created by the company. Please also take a look at that. So this is Michael, and thank you so much for what. I hope you can subscribe to my channel. Thanks, guys. Goodbye.